While the cornerstone of railway safety has been the safety management system since the start of the new century, the concept of safety culture was introduced with the publication of the fourth railway package in 2016. A few months later, the European Union Agency for Railways launched an ambitious program to develop a positive safety culture, for which the European Railway Safety Culture Model brings theoretical foundations. The objective of today's webinar is to introduce this tool that we have been using to build a common understanding of the concept, and which also constitutes a framework to evaluate and improve the safety culture of railway companies. I will start giving some background information of the safety culture concept. This to present several rather strong principles that we have used during the design process of the model. A first reading of the model will then highlight the key distinction between organizational culture and safety culture, followed by a second reading, which will describe a safety culture assessment framework currently used by railway organizations and national safety authorities. I will finally share with you current and future developments and make some concluding remarks before the Q&A session. It is commonly accepted to associate the birth of the concept of safety culture with accidents such as Chernobyl, Challenger, and in the railway sector, the Clapham Junction collision in the UK. On one hand, it has been developed emphasizing how much inappropriate behaviors at all levels contributed to these disastrous events. On the other, the concept refers to features that strongly shape group behaviors, recognizing organizational and cultural factors as safety dimensions. This acknowledgement is reflected by most of the hundreds of definitions of safety culture that have been elaborated in all domains: aviation, nuclear, oil and gas, healthcare. My first challenge for this webinar would be not to quote any of them. This actually reveals our state of mind when we decided to conceive the European Railway Safety Culture Model. The assumption was that we, but definitely also our stakeholders, needed more than a definition to approach the concept. My understanding of the model here is simple and well defined by the cognitive scientist Marvin Minsky. A model of safety culture is something that can be used to answer questions about safety culture. Three important principles initially guided us when elaborating the model. First one, the model should be useful for all our stakeholders, whether they are infrastructure managers, railway undertakings, for passengers, for freight, entities in charge of maintenance, service providers, national safety authorities, national investigating bodies, etc. Second principle, the model should distinguish the two words, safety and culture. They are very different concepts in the sense that culture is value-free, to quote the scientist from Goldenmund, while safety is not. What I mean by value-free is the following. Any group, when working together to achieve a common goal, develops an organizational culture. It is not to be qualified as good or bad. Safety is not value-free. On the contrary, one can clearly designate what is a safe behavior and what is not. Last principle, the model should be practical and help to identify areas for improvement. However, it should not oversimplify the concept. There was a clear wish to respect it. Culture is a matter of ethnographics who spend lots of time interacting with a group before daring revealing cultural markers. We did not want culture to end in a numerical dashboard, nor to reduce it to a simplistic KPI. For designing the model, we created a task force under the umbrella of our Human and Organizational Factors Network with professionals from a great variety of member states, diverse types of railway organizations and authorities. We met 3 times during 6 months and we elaborated the first mock-up, which was presented during the European Rail Human and Organizational Factors Seminar in Valenciennes in November 2018.